You are watching Skyrim commentary from Shauna Films.
Oh, I was wondering why my frame rate was getting so bad. It's because this guy was invisible and trying to sneak up on me.
That's even better than fireballs.
But like right now, the sun's out, but there's not much shadow on the ground. I need to figure out how to get this exact look right here. There's still shading on everything. There's just no shadows from the sun, and I don't know what EMB values my game had to get this look. And so I installed this mod. It's a guy, some dude. He uses Kodlak's voice for his character. He sounded interesting.
At least a skiva. I don't know if I like this.
What I'm almost tempted to do is uninstall the EMB that I am using and update to the latest, greatest version. And then just look around and see what profiles are written for it that look decent. Because I'm at a point now where I'm using a preset written for an older ENB that I'm not using. But I can't use the older EMB anymore because it wants to phone home. See, all of these ENBs written for Skyrim, they all want to phone home. Like spyware almost. And you know, antivirus programs have a heck of a time with EMB installers because they see that it's almost self-modifying code. And it wants to phone home. And if a server gets turned off or gets broken, that EMB. The EMB becomes useless. Another thing that was bugging me was this bear here. The bear, no matter what I would do, the bear would get stuck in a rock. There's a glitch. Somehow his the respawning of the bear was messed up, so it would always pathfind itself to that rock and be attached to the rock and not be able to move.
We did well. Also.
So we're slowly working our way up this hill.
Or at least a skiva.
Okay, so this guy that we're looking for who talks like Kodlak, he has his own house up here. It's a mishmash of Nightgate Inn and the Hall of the Vigilance. Normally when you come up this way, you just run into the hunters and that's it. You go back down. There's nothing more to see up here. I'm all taking people's stuff. They don't care. There's some sort of nav mesh issues. That's why my machine was a little bit hiccuping coming up the ladder here, the steps. The person that made this mod put the wrong door on the thing. That's an interior door that they stuck on the outside of a building. And there's no journal for that map marker that's on the door, saying where that door leads to. Really? Come on. Let's go. Stop lollygagging, as they say. Great. So, see how it opened and there's a door underneath it? Yeah, that's not how you do mods. Like, that's not how you make a house. So we're in the exact copy of the Hall of Vigilance. And there he is. It's however you pronounce that. That's who it is. And I need this for an orc stronghold. They need me to bring troll fat and a Daedric heart, so I'm just grabbing it.
A stranger comes to our hall. Greetings, outsider. If you have some business here, speak it. My title is Harbinger, child. I am no man's master. Nearly 5,000 years old. Yes, it's true. But the reality is more complicated than that. Well, I grow old. My mind turns towards the horizon, to Sovngarde. I worry that Shor won't call an animal to glory as he would a true Nord warrior. I keep searching for some hope of Sovngarde, but to no avail. Would you now? Here, let me have a look at you. Yes, perhaps. A certain strength of spirit. Let's not waste too much time talking when there is glory to be had.
Okay, so already I like this guy. He's got some character. He underwent a few updates while I was trying him out. So, you know,
this is not the military. There are no ranks.
Because I'm pretty good at picking apart companions, and so I immediately post things that are not quite right, and you know, within a day or two, there's a fix. So I was impressed by the speed at which stuff was getting updated. I couldn't remember the floor plan of this place, because it gets destroyed so early in my game. This is basically a clone of the Hall of the Vigilant. And I thought there was a basement around here. I did find it later on. There is a basement to this place.
How goes the hunt? Well, boy, you're one of us now. I trust you all.
So the modder picked a good voice to edit and use for
well,
the companion.
Boy. Leave that to me. We'll get to that.
Now, apparently there was quite an effort was made to get this ported over to Special Edition. Because beards like this just don't work in Special Edition, for the most part.
But we can overcome.
Special Edition has a more more robust, less more was it less forgiving? More robust renderer than Skyrim Legendary Edition does. I mean, you don't notice right now, but his beard It has polygons that are reversed on the thing. And that's a no-no in Skyrim Special Edition.
Are you still here?
You know, the game will just outright crash. So, Trip...
Yes, boss?
Ah, what's that person's name? All right. Trip the Rift? Is that what their name is? The person that did Sassy Teens and The Kids Are Alright. And a bunch of other mods. I think her name is Trip the Rift. Anyway. They were able to fix all the problems with this guy so that he would work in Special Edition. So I don't know if there's a Special Edition version up or if it's being beta tested at the moment. But they figured out how to get weird beards to work in Special Edition. Because this guy does have the weird beard going on. Because there's someone named Divided by the Nines, was it 27 divided by the Nines, something like that. And
yes, young lady.
They're real sloppy. They're real sloppy when it comes to making mods, making assets for mods, armors,
now be gone.
Body parts,
how goes the hunting
textures book? For mods. But Legendary Edition could care less.
Talos guide you.
If you do a crap mod, guess what? You get to play a crap mod in Skyrim. But Special Edition is a bit more picky if your mod is crap or not.
Young one.
So someone was mentioning that his beard is a bit too bright or a bit too glowy.
Get a move on.
And I thought, so I was trying to get him to come to the light. You know, the sun... I don't even know if the sun was going up or the sun was going down. But his beard does kind of glow a bit. It's a bit bright.
I hear you've been busy of late.
So there is an option to use a gray beard instead of a white beard.
You fight well, brother.
Maybe the beard looks better in a certain EMB. God, I wish I could get my...
Still here?
My current install of Skyrim to look this good. I don't know. I don't know what settings I was using. I should have saved a backup of the EMB files, you know, the INI files, before I deleted my Skyrim folder.
I wander, weary and lost.
Because I've made some changes to the default profile I was using for NLA 2.0. Anyway, I was just getting him to go to different parts of this area where there's different shadowing and shading going on so I can get a good look at his beard. And there's a stupid exit. Exit marker on the front of the door instead of on the back side of the door. It's on the front side of the door. And there's no map marker in the journal about where that even goes. It's like, why? What is that? What is that for? What is that about? So I mentioned it to the person and they said, oh yeah, I'm using the wrong door for the outside of the building is all. So that's been fixed since this recording. Maybe I had some clouds installed. Obsidian clouds or something? Or... And that may have changed something.
How goes the hunt?
Because I want my game to look like this again. Right now it doesn't.
Lad. He might just make it.
I'm trying to get him to face a certain way so I can check out his beard. Okay, this is good. Stay there. I need a before after picture. Because right now his beard's kind of glowy. So what I'll do is I'll install the dark beard. Okay, let's get him to turn around here. So now he's got a gray beard.
Get a move. One of my predecessors was a good but short-sighted man. He made a bargain with the witches of Glenmoral Coven.
Yeah, his beard's a little bit darker. It doesn't glow as much. I think that was the beard they ended up giving him as a default. And the white beard was just taken out. You're not going to fall off that bridge, are you? Oh, too many people. Too many people on this little nav mesh here. And I didn't know this, but he rides a bear. So I'm thinking, you know what? Let's get on our horses. I want to see if he has a horse or something.
Something I can get for you? You've done well.
Greetings.
And first thing I noticed about him is that he warps. When my back is
how goes the hunt?
When my back is turned, he warps right to me.
Let's not waste too much time.
Okay, I can live with that color beard. It's not too glowy. The horn blowing he does, that's a random thing he does. That's he'll read a book, he'll blow his horn. He'll do some sight searching. I was curious if he would be naked if I took his clothes off or what.
Talos guide you.
So I don't know what body he's using.
I worry that Shore won't call an animal to glory.
They gave him an old man body? Is that what happened? I don't remember what mod was used for this guy.
Let's not waste too much time talking.
He's a standalone mod, so you don't have to install any weird guy fiddly bits for him. He comes with all of it.
Glory in battle, honor in life.
So I made the farmer clothes his default. That way, if I give him armor, he'll put it on, because before he wouldn't wear anything else with the armor he came with.